Blessed is our God, who is now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, O God, glory to you, O heavenly King, comforter of the Spirit of truth, who are present in all places and filling all things, the treasury of good things and giver of life. Come and dwell within us, cleanse us of every stain, and save our souls of evil.
Amen. Holy God, holy night, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy night, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy night, holy immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. All hope and Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us in our sin. Master, forgive our transgressions, holy ones, and consider our weaknesses, and yield them for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, to the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For that is the kingdom and the power of the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Lord, save your people and bless your inheritance. Grant them victory to the faithful of God, service and protecting the commonwealth by your cross. Vox apothe Dei, O King, you open up. Lifted up on the cross by your free will, Christ, God, and our mercies to the new commonwealth of God's name. The Adam of faithful rulers by your power, give them victory over the adversary. Dear lads, be from the Lord, ever from peace and invincible standing. Yen in Dei, I in Dei, as you say, always from the Lord, amen. Awesome and unfailing protection in us, for our supplications, gracious in all prayers, they have offered. Uphold the Orthodox Commonwealth. Preserve those you have called to govern and grant them victory from on high. While you rule the only blessed one, give glory to God.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians.
Hasten to help me, O Lord, my salvation. And you, Lord, O Lord, I have placed my trust in you. You, O Lord, my God, hasten to help me, O Lord, in my salvation.
O God, my God, in honor I rise to you, my soul has thirsted for you, and O how my flesh has hungered for you. Like the desolate and trackless land of death and water, she doesn't come before you in your holy places, to the power and the glory that are yours. But your love is better than life, and top my lips shall declare your praise. They shall bless you as long as I live, and lift up my hand and call upon your name. My soul shall be filled with choice and spirit, and your soul will praise your name. As I lay on my couch, I'll remember you. I'll meditate on you throughout your watches. You came for me to help me when in the shelter of your wings, I will find delight. My soul clings to you in your right hand, hold me up. But as for those who took my life and made the day seek me to possess the earth, to be given over to the sword and prey of jackals, they shall be. That the king shall rejoice in God, and all his word by you shall roar through the mouth of lions and stalk. I meditated on you throughout your watches. You came for me to help me when in the shelter of your wings, I will find delight. My soul clings to you in your right hand, hold me up. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Glory to you, God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Giving me a time to be down, and stretch my life into the ground, and force me to live in darkness like those long dead.
Father Salvus, the Honorable Presbyter of the Diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
For this, for our country, for the President, for all public service, and for the armed forces everywhere, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who live in that, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
For favorable weather, for an abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
For those who travel by land, sea, and air, for the sake of the suffering, the captives, and for their salvation, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
For mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
For mercy.
Remembering your all holy, your most blessed and glorious Lady, the veil of all most and ever virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us commend ourselves to one another and our whole life to Christ our God. For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you.
the Lord.
Have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Have mercy.
Remembering our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, the failed office and ever Virgin Mary with all the saints, let us commend ourselves one another in our whole life to Christ our God. Blessed is your holy name, and glorified is your kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the age.
crown that has been given by the Lord to you, O faithful and divine heirs. Restore your wisdom together in this singing. Rejoice the joy of all, us all.
Rejoice the joy of us all.
Send me wisdom from heaven as I try to tell of your many renowned deeds. As the one who makes the foolish wise by divine inspiration and a spring of wisdom, he clearly grant me the gift of words as I open my mouth, so that rejoicing I may sing in him the finding of your sacred icon, which you were well pleased to give as a gift to the audience of the bride of God. And grant me strength from on high to give the strengthening of the paralytic, the inexpressible healing of the unconscious one, the salvation of the sailors in danger, the putting out of the thunderbolts and fire, the removal of pestilent diseases, the stopping of the arrows of the pirates, the cessation of the rainless drought, the healing of those suffering from incurable diseases, and all your other miracles through which you are shown to be shelter, protection, and champion, firm protector, and fortification of the city, benefactor and loving mother of the people of the city. Therefore, giving your compassion for us with faith and boundless yearning. With contrition of soul, I cry to you, O Virgin, rejoice the joy of us all. On September 24th, commemorate the holy great martyr Thecla, heir of the apostles. We remember the great miracle of the mother of God on the island of Thea, where the icon of Theotokos was founded in myrrh, bush, and healed the paralytic. By the intercessions of our Virgin, to God, have mercy on us, amen.
My mouth shall open wide, thus we fear you.
Amen.
Shall turn back to you.
Deliver me from that guilt and by the guard of my salvation, my conscience, bring your
Apostle Glorious Prophet and Forerunner John the Baptist, of the Holy Glorious and Praiseworthy Apostles, of our Fathers among the Saints, the Great High Arts and Ecumenical Teachers, Basil the Great Greek Theologian and John Chrysostom, Athanasius and Cyril John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas Bishop of Mira, Lysias, Spirit, our Bishop of Prometheus, Nicodemus, Phanopolis, John Maximus, Bishop Shanghai, San Francisco, Sarah, and Sarah, the Wonder Workers, of the Holy Hierarch, of the Holy Glorious Martyrs, that of the Holy Glorious Martyrs, Lord's Victorious Demetrius and Rome, Peter the Recruit, Peter the Commander, the Gnostic Wonder Worker, that I was left that is the priest martyrs of the Holy Glorious Great Martyr, mercy, heal all those who run to your divine temple faithfully. Gladness and happiness and serenity of soul, and you spread out your saving grace over all who come to entreat you and venerate with longing your august and holy icon, O Lady, full of the grace of God.
Lord, Son, Jesus, Jesus. Orthodox, to be
Virgin Mary with all the saints. Let us defend ourselves and one another in our whole life. forever and for the ages of ages.
Okay.
Diego.
Thank you.
intercede and speed now to supplicate as a protection for all time. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
You are God, our holy, to you we offer our glory, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Holy, holy, holy,
Jacob to Nazareth. And he saw two boats by the lake, but the fishermen had gone out of them, washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, which was Simon's, he asked him to put out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people from the boat. And when he had ceased speaking, he said to Simon, put out into the deep and let your nets down for a catch. And Simon answered, Master, we toiled all night and took nothing, but at your word I will let down the nets. And when they had said done this, they enclosed a great shoal of fish. And as the nets were breaking, they beckoned to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. They came and filled both boats, so that they began to sink. But when Simon Peter saw it, he fell down at Jesus' knees, saying, Depart from me, for I am a sinful man, O Lord. For he was astonished, and all who were with him, at the catch of fish which were taken. So also were James and John, sons of Zebedee, who were partners with Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, Do not be afraid, henceforth you will be catching men. And when they had brought their boats to the land, they left everything and followed him.
Thank you.
Let us love one another, that with oneness of mind we may confess.
Oh,
is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins.
Again and again.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Give thanks, Lord.
Precious gifts you presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord.
Give thanks, Lord.
That our God, who loves mankind, having accepted them at his holy and celestial and mystical altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Oh.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Christ is in our midst.
He is in our midst.
Beloved, today we have in our gospel a wonderful story. A story that as we begin the readings from the Gospel of Luke, this is the first Sunday that we hear from the Gospel of Luke during the whole year when it comes to the year of the church year. We've been hearing from the Gospel of Matthew. The church year doesn't begin on January 1st, by the way. So this is the first time that we are listening to the Gospel of Luke. And just like the first time we hear from the Gospel of Matthew, we hear Jesus calling the fishermen. We hear him calling his disciples. And by extension, the one thing that we need to get from this, you know, in whatever fashion, in whatever form, whenever we hear the calling of the fishermen, it is the Lord and the church calling us. There is no, you can't mix the words about it. God, when we hear these gospels, the gospel by which he has called those people that are going to serve him and to serve the ministry on this earth, he is calling each and every one of us. That's what he's doing. Okay, this isn't something that, oh, look at that, it's nice. Look at these 12 guys, how Jesus called them. He's calling us. Because the 12 fishermen aren't here anymore. And the message has to keep going. So we're the ones. That's us. We're the ones chartered. Not at all, although I am, by virtue of my ordination. But all of us are called to go out. Called to be apostles and disciples. And we're supposed to spread this message. What is this message? Right? I mean, the message had to have been a really, really good message. Because, I mean, the gospel tells us. The gospel tells us how important this message was. He even said, he got into one of the boats which was Simon. This is what the gospel tells us today. He got into the boat which was Simon's, and he asked him to put out a little from the land. Why would he do this? He was going to go teach. He sat down and taught the people from the boat. Why would he put out a little bit from the land, right? You know, it's like, hey, I'm going to talk to you, and I'm going to start walking away from you so I can talk to you. You know, you wouldn't understand what I was doing. Why did he do this? Why did he do this? He did this because he wanted everyone to see him. And he wanted everyone to sit down and pay attention. Everyone, he wanted them to get, understand, and know what the message of the gospel was. And the other thing that we have to understand with the fact that he got out from the boat was the large crowd of people that were just waiting to hear from him. Now, you know, I walk down the corner of Steubenville, or I walk down the corner of Cleveland, or I walk down the corner of Columbus, or I walk down the corner of Pittsburgh, and I start preaching, people are going to start walking away from me. People are going to start running. They don't want to hear this message. They don't want to hear the word of the Lord. Has the word of the Lord changed? No. Have we changed? Maybe. Not really. Society certainly has. The message is a message. We got to remember how impressive this message was. Flocks, multitudes of people were hungry to hear it. And you can't cheat and say, well, it's Jesus. We can't cheat ourselves. We can't say, well, Jesus, oh my goodness, you know, look at how Jesus, and he taught, and he was Jesus, and he's our Lord. And of course he's going to teach and preach better than everyone else. Okay, fine. I'll give you that. But not everyone listened to him, including those that were the most learned. They thought they knew better. We've been hearing this message this way our whole lives. What are you telling us? How dare you teach us? That's what the most learned of this society were saying. But not only that, it's not just his impressive teaching. Even the apostles, when they began teaching, thousands upon thousands were called and baptized in Christ. It's the message. It's the message. Not only that, but the message was so powerful, it called a person. This is important. Saint Thecla. You may say, okay, what is this? Thecla. You know, maybe some people have heard this name, some people in the Orthodox definitely have heard this name, because I say it every Orthodox service, you will hear the name Saint Thecla. She is called Proto-Martyr. Those of you who know the names of the saints, who is the Proto-Martyr? Stephen, right. Stephen is the Proto-Martyr. He was the first one. What is the church saying? Calling her Proto-Martyr. She's the first woman to be martyred. You want to talk about an egalitarian church, right? We've been doing this for years, for centuries. Women have been treated in the most proper way. How is she martyred? I'll tell you how she was martyred. This will knock your boat, this will knock your socks off. She was engaged to be married to the most prominent individual in Iconium. That's the city where she lived. The most prominent individual in Iconium. She was engaged to be married to him. And she was in her room. She was in her house. And she eventually walked up to her room. She was tired for preparation. She was doing all the rest of these things. She was betrothed to be married. She was in her house. She went upstairs into her house. And all of a sudden, she was listening outside of her window. They didn't have, you know, double plane soundproof glass in those days on their windows. They just had a window. She's in her house listening to in the window. And all of a sudden, from next door, she heard a guy preaching and teaching the message of the faith. She heard St. Paul. He was literally next door to her. She had never heard the message of the Lord before in her life. And she listened to St. Paul, and she got so enamored with the message of the church, with the good news, the gospel of Christ, she got so enamored that for 3 days, she didn't leave that window. 3 days. She didn't come down for meals. She slept only when she didn't hear the message anymore. And she sat with her ear up to that window, listening for this beautiful message that was being preached by St. Paul. Never left. Never walked away. Never doubted that what St. Paul was saying, she never heard this before. Never doubted for one second that what St. Paul was saying was needed for her life. And even when her betrothed called her, she still stayed by the window. Because you know, you're engaged to somebody, you got things that happen, the betrothed calls, and we got to make some preparations, we got to do whatever. This is, of course, you know, the woman likes to make preparations and things like this, the guy, not always. You know, so they're doing the things that they need to do. No, she wouldn't leave. Finally, she hears that St. Paul is being in prison, and you know, she goes to find him. And she goes into prison, and the betrothed gets jealous because she's like, "Who is this man? That has my wife and my wife to be in trance. Who is this?" So he goes to see him and starts threatening him and brings him before the courts. And instead of standing by her betrothed, she stands by Paul. She stands by his feet. And when Paul is delivered, they had a separate torture for her. She was supposed to be run over by wild animals. That's what was supposed to happen. They were supposed to feed her to the lions and to bears. And when they saw her, Paul had been saved already. When they saw her, when the first lioness saw her, immediately she came, turned around, and growled all the other animals so fiercely that none of the animals dare approach not only Thecla, but the lioness. And she went through several torches, some of which are kind of gruesome. But every time that she went through a torture, every time she went through a torture and a trial, she was saved from everything. And this is a person who literally just heard the message preached once from her window and for 3 days could not leave it, and because of that, she gave her life over to God. This message must be our most powerful. By the way, even though she's called proto-martyr, she actually died in peace. She actually never died as a result of her martyrdom. But her witness for Christ, her witness was in those trials by which she showed others how powerful our Lord is. So the question becomes today, brothers and sisters in Christ, how powerful is the Lord in our lives? How powerful is he? How powerful is he? How much do we allow God to work in our lives? Do we let him? Is he free to do what he wishes? Is he free to show us exactly the manner in which we need to behave? Or do we give God, you know, a little maze? All right, you've got to turn left here, Lord. You've got to turn left here. Then okay, now we've got to the place where you can work in my life. If you're like me, I set up a maze, unfortunately. It's not the way it should be. God needs to be acting freely in our lives. He needs to be not confined by our sin, by our self-will, by our pride, by our guilty, angry, upset feelings, or hurt nature. He needs to be unequivocally free from all of that. For us to be the witnesses of our Lord, not just for the people out of these walls, but even for each other. The message of our Lord, after all, as we just heard it, in the last 3 weeks, we've heard what the message of the Lord is. It is that God so loved us that he sent his Son, his only Son, to heal and to save us. That message has got to be preached. And that there is a response to it should be understood. A response of love. A response of joy. Not a response of obligation. God doesn't want us to be obligated to him. He wants us to love him. He wants us to freely give ourselves over. What it looks like is St. Beck. A person that no matter what was coming in front of her, she would not leave the Lord for one second. Not leave the message for one minute. Not leave the ministry of the Lord for one part of her life. What she knew. She's called not just proto-martyr. She is also called equal to the apostles. This is how powerful the saint we commemorate today is. That's how powerful the message can be if it is allowed to be spoken freely from our lives and from our lips. Today, we must ask ourselves, how free is God to work in our lives? And can we make him more free? In the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Please rise. We will say together a communion of prayer.
I believe and confess, Lord, that you are truly the Christ, the Son of the living God, who came into the world to save sinners, of whom I am the first. I also believe that this is truly your God, and that this is truly your precious blood. Therefore I praise you, have mercy upon me, and forgive my transgressions, voluntary and involuntary, word and deed, known and unknown, and make me worthy without condemnation,
sins, and for life eternal. Amen. How shall I, O Lord, enter into the son of your saints? If I dare to enter to our latter chamber, my clothing will accuse me, since it is not a wedding garment, and being bound up, I shall be cast out by the angel. In your love, Lord, cleanse my soul to save me. Loving Master, O Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let not these holy gifts be to my congregation, because of my unworthiness, but for cleansing and sanctification of soul and body, and the pledge of the future life of me. It is good for me to cling to God, and to place in him the hope of my salvation. Receiving the very Son of God, as a partaker in his sister's supper, I will not forgive you, Mr.
And the fault with the obese, they will stand up, these cross health with them, with the fear of God, with faith and with love, draw near.
Amen.
Sos Theos, Nostrum, et nois of the Deuteronomiensu. O God, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Yeah. to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Father, bless.
May he who rose from the dead, Christ, our true God, through the intercession of his all-immaculate and all-blameless Holy Mother, the commemoration of the miracle of her icon, the Mirti Diocesis of Kikida, whose memory we commemorate today, by the power of the precious light, the cross, protect the honor of his powers of heaven, suffocating the honor of the glorious apostles, the honor of the Baptist, the holy glorious Christ, the apostles, the glorious Christ, the martyrs, the venerable God, the sacred fathers, of our Father, and all the saints, prophets, and martyrs, the holy apostles, 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 about a whole lot more than this. So please,
even if you're not involved in the basketball program because of whatever sports or other things that are coming up, please come to this kickoff so you can get an idea of the kinds of things that we are setting ourselves up for this year. It's going to be exciting and a very good planning meeting. So please make that effort to come and to, if you have a child or are a parent that has a child of that age. We, of course, welcome into our community Deacon Everpides. I just demoted him. He's not just deacon, he is archdeacon. Archdeacon Everpides. I was there when he was made an archdeacon. So he is here visiting his brother, George, and he was able to join us this day for Holy Communion, for Divine Liturgy. So it is our joy, Deacon Everpides. It's good to see you. It is a joy to have you in our midst. That is all that I had to announce, unless there's something else that people... Okay, wonderful. Please come forward then to receive your blessing.
Thank you.